Hi everybody, Mark Wild, CEO Crossrail here, and it's a pleasure to give you the latest update from the programme as we strive to get the Elizabeth line open. Big milestone achieved for the programme in recent days, we commenced trial operations. Trial operations is the final stage of the programme prior to opening. It's the time we conduct a dress rehearsal, practice all the operational scenarios that will occur in the real railway to make sure that we're ready for when this railway opens. It's been a busy year for us, particularly since we transitioned in March to an operational railway. Since then, we've done three things. Firstly, we've run hundreds of thousands of timetabled train miles to shake down the system, find all the bugs and the defects in this immense, complicated digital system. Secondly, we've brought the signalling software and the tunnel ventilation system in particular up to the right quality, very, very close to revenue quality software. That's been one of the major events of the past 6 months. And finally, I'm very pleased to report that we've completed the complicated routeway integration tests. These are the tests that could only be done once the railway has come together in its completed form, and they form the backbone of the final safety assurance that obviously customers will rely upon when we open the Elizabeth line. With that work behind us, we now look forward to trial operations. During trial operations, there will be 150 planned and unplanned exercises, drills and practices that'll throw everything at our brilliant operational teams to make sure they are match fit for the opening of the Elizabeth line. The second thing we'll do during this phase is complete some relatively small number but important tweaks to the signalling software and in particular the tunnel ventilation system. These are the results of the great amount of testing we've done during the past year, and they're essential to get the right safety and reliability for the Elizabeth line, which we all know is paramount in this drive to the opening. These final tweaks to the tunnel ventilation system are particularly important because amongst the 150 planned and unplanned trial operations exercises, we have six particular exercises where thousands of colleagues help us practice the scenarios that will occur in real life. We aim to commence them in the new year. Until then though, we are getting on with the other 144 scenarios. They started at the weekend and so far it's going well. Of course, when we open the Elizabeth line, it's very important that we have the right reliability, because this railway has to work not just on day one, it has to work on every single day after that. That's why we still have an opening window of the first half of 2022. We aim to narrow that window as soon as we have confidence in the reliability growth. And of course, our aspiration is to get as early as possible in that opening window, and we will have much better information after Christmas once we've been through the upcoming software tweaks and also got a good way into trial operations. Thank you for everybody being patient regarding that. But I think we all appreciate that the most important thing after 10 years of construction and delivery is that we have a reliable railway when we open. Elsewhere in the programme, I am here today at the completed Liverpool Street station. Liverpool Street is one of the eight completed and handed over stations to TfL. There are only two remaining in the central section, Canary Wharf and Bond Street. Canary Wharf is well advanced and we will have that transferred to TfL by the end of the year. And at Bond Street, I'm very pleased to report that Bond Street now is ready to support trial operations. The team are doing a great job at Bond Street and they're catching up fast. Of course, the Elizabeth line is more than just this iconic central section. We continue to run the railway east and west with 9-car full-length units now operating on the eastern leg from Shenfield to Liverpool Street. The stations in the west are complete at the surface level, and in the east we only have Ilford and Romford to complete, and our partner Network Rail are doing well to get those complete in the early part of next year. I hope people have found this update informative and useful. The Elizabeth line will open in the first half of 2022, and it's our absolute passion to have the earliest possible opening date within that window. Rest assured that we know how much London and the whole country needs this project to complete and the Elizabeth line to open, and we will be trying our very best over the next 2 or 3 months to make that a reality. Thank you very much.